start our US Air Force 70th anniversary commemoration. The sole example of its type flying in Europe today, this is Barry B-17G Flying Fortress, South Beach. The Army Air Corps in 1926, and then in 1941, the US Army Air Force. All the while, there were many proponents of an independent air arm, and that was finally achieved with the foundation of the US Air Force itself on the 18th of September, 1947. Now, the Air Force was a full partner in the US Armed Services alongside the Army and Navy. But the B-17 that we see here takes us back to the era of the US Army Air Corps, and particularly the Army Air Force. It was the Corps that requested a new multi-engine bomber in the mid-1930s. That request was taken up by Boeing with a design known as the Model 299. From design to its first flight in July 1935, it took less than a year. That was the aircraft that became the B-17. Army Air Force by the time of the Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor that brought America into the war on the 7th of December 1941. The Royal Air Force was another early user, albeit with not much in the way of success. Number 90 Squadron was the first RIAT unit to fly the fortress. By the time daylight raids were abandoned by RIAT Bomber Command, half of that squadron's mission with the fortress has been aborted without bombs being dropped. That experience shows that the B-17s have better defensive armament, a bigger bomb load, and better bomb aiming equipment. And when US Army Air Force aircraft of the 8th Air Force began to be stationed in the UK during 1942 for operations in the European theatre, it would have all of those on its early B-17s. The first flying fortress raid by the 8th Air Force was made by the 97th Bomb Group stationed at Holbrook in Northamptonshire, escorted by Royal Air Force Spitfires to the marshalling yards of the railroads at Rouen in France in August, 75 years ago this year. And in this piece of audio, we can hear some period accounts of what it was like to fly a B-17 on one of the early 1942 raids by the 8th Air Force over Germany.
The fortress was seen to flatten down, gathering way and lift, out toward the continent, out toward the end. The ground crews watching and hoping, their half of the job done. Now the ship is operating out. Where the way out force in formation. Keeping station, each plane helps to cover the other. Together they make one round bristling hedgehog of fire. The pale, glimmering English sun and the English shield checkerboard below. Americans from Massachusetts, Idaho, and Kentucky. A long, long way from home. The target is the one. The railroad yards. They come in from the northeast in kite formation, very hard, visible from the ground, and make their bombing run as well. Thank you. B-17s return safe.
Not to Germany, as I said, but to France in the summer of 1942. The main Air Force tactic was daylight raids against German industrial facilities and transport and resupply networks, likes of rail marshalling yards and rail junctions. But initially there was no escort fighter available to escort the B-17s and their colleagues, the consolidated B-24 liberators, all the way to their targets. Later, however, the likes of the Republic P-47 Thunderbolt and the aircraft we're about to see, the North American P-51 Mustang, changed all that. They could accommodate, accompany the bombers deep into Germany and come back. Losses decreased as the Allies gained air superiority, though flak was still a danger, even to the legendarily tough B-17. Conditions on board the 8th Air Force heavy bombers at altitude were pretty hellish. It was noisy, it was cold, there was little in the way of protective armour plating or personal protective equipment, and of course that's even before one thinks of the threat of enemy action. B-17 itself carried on being used by the post-war US Air Force. They were used for weather reconnaissance duties during the Berlin airlift. They were used for search and rescue support, for example, during the Korean War, carrying a 27-foot-long airborne lifeboat under the fuselage. This B-17G model dated from 1945, the sole airworthy B-17 remaining in Europe, privately operated from IWM Duxford by B-17 Preservation Limited, under the remarkable leadership of the aircraft operator, Ellie Salisbury. It's incredible to think that a four-engine heavy bomber from the Second World War has remained operational in private hands with nothing in the way of official support on the UK and European display circuit for now 42 years. There have been tough times along the way. Always the aircraft has bounced back. That in no small part thanks to the generosity of the worldwide membership of the Sally B Supporters Club. All the funds raised by the club go towards the continued maintenance of this aircraft in airworthy condition as a memorial to the men of the United States Army Air Force. And here we see it with smoke on two engines simulating an aircraft returning from a raid. Final pass, as always, dedicated to the members of the Sally B Supporters Club. You can join up and find out more details by going to the website at www.sallyb.org. Indeed, it's not just the American airmen to whom Sally B pays continued tribute, but the sacrifice made by all Allied airmen during the Second World War.